Hello and welcome. You're logged on to IndianTimesDaily.com, the only portal for news from India, America, Canada, Punjab and Gujarat in English, Punjabi and Gujarati with a list of well-established businesses and resources that you may need. I'm Annie Sheikh and today's headlines are: In India, Pakistan is planning a permanent ban on JUD and other terror groups, and non-bailable warrants have been issued against Diamantris, Nirav Modi and Mehul Choksi. In America, a Sikh group has set a world record to celebrate the Turban Day, and Pakistan has urged the US to resume its balancing role in South Asia. In Punjab, new BJP state chief Shoaib Malik has slammed the state Congress, and a number of illegal migrants from the state to Gulf countries has risen. Stay tuned to IndianTimesDaily.com and I'll be back with all the news that's important for you from India, America and Punjab. Welcome back to Indian Times Daily. The top 10 headlines from India are: Pakistan is drafting a bill to ban terror organizations like Mumbai terror attack mastermind Hafiz Saeed led JUD, as well as individuals on the Interior Ministry watch list. India and the US have repeatedly pressurized Islamabad to curb terror activities. Non-bailable warrants have been issued against Diamantaraya Nirav Modi and his uncle Mehul Choksi in connection with ₹13,500 crore PNB fraud. Both the diamond traders who left the country in January refused to join the investigation in cases related to the scam. The Chinese military has strongly protested against what it called the Indian Army's transgression into the strategically sensitive Asafela area along the disputed border in Arunachal Pradesh. The Indian side, however, roundly dismissed the complaint. PM Narendra Modi has congratulated the Indian women's table tennis team, weightlifters and shooters on winning medals in the 21st Commonwealth Games. He stated that every Indian took pride in their accomplishments. A group of 21 TDP MPs were on Sunday detained by the police while marching towards PM Narendra Modi's residence. They were demanding special status for Andhra Pradesh. The Congress has accused PM Narendra Modi of maintaining a stoic silence over the concerns of Dalits. The Congress added that Modi's silence indicated that the BJP and RSS were working towards a Dalit Mukt Bharat. Protests were held last week over the dilution of SCST Act. A wife is not a chattel or an object, and she cannot be forced to reside with her husband even if the man desires to live with her, the Supreme Court has said. The judge made the observation during the hearing of women seeking divorce on grounds of cruelty. Five hardcore Maoist guerrillas have been arrested in Jharkhand. A country-made pistol, two air guns, one pistol and three mobiles were seized from the five who were arrested during a police checking on the highway. The Health Ministry has banned over-the-counter sale of around 14 creams to prevent the indiscriminate sale of topical preparations containing steroids and antibiotics without prescription. Dermatologists had complained the pharmaceutical companies were selling steroid-based creams and ointments to patients who use them without medical guidance. Bollywood megastar Amitabh Bachchan and Anil Kapoor are ecstatic over the performance of India's women athletes at the 21st Commonwealth Games in Australia. The women athletes have won 4 gold medals so far this year. Stay tuned to Indian Times Daily as news from America and Punjab follows. Welcome back to Indian Times Daily. The top 10 headlines from America are: A Sikh organization in the US has created a world record by tying thousands of turbans within few hours. Community members commemorated the annual Turban Day at the iconic Times Square in New York. They were spreading awareness about the faith amid incidents of hate crimes against the community. Pakistan has asked the US to resume the balancing role that it played in South Asia before its tilt towards India, claiming that the move has created an imbalance in the region. India was the only country in which the Trump administration came out with a 100-year plan, an honor not even accorded to Americans' top allies. Hackers have attacked networks in a number of countries, including data centers in Iran, when they left the image of US flag on screens. The message on screen said, "Don't mess with our elections." The attack, which hit internet service providers and cut off web access for subscribers, mainly affected Europe, India and the United States. India is keeping its option open to join other affected countries in the WTO against the steel and aluminium tariff hikes imposed by the Trump administration. India has expressed its surprise and disappointment over the US decision to include it in a list of countries that will face higher tariffs. President Donald Trump has said that Beijing will ease trade barriers because it is the right thing to do amid rising concerns about a possible trade war. However, China has threatened to retaliate if Washington follows through with proposed tariffs. North Korea is prepared to discuss the denuclearization of the Korean Peninsula when Kim Jong-un meets President Donald Trump. Both the leaders had surprised the world by swiftly agreeing to meet each other to discuss the crisis over Pyongyang's development of nuclear weapons. President Donald Trump has condemned Syria for the chemical attack, saying that there would be a big price to pay against the attack on a besieged rebel-held town. Around 49 people have died due to the poison gas in the town of Douma. The Syrian state has denied any role. An elderly man has died after a blaze erupted on the 50th floor on Trump Tower in New York. Four firefighters were also injured. Streets surrounding the building owned by the US president that serves as the headquarters for the Trump Organization and houses his penthouse were closed off. Chilly winds bringing light snow and sleet have covered much of the central and eastern US, making weather still winter-like. Wind chills for nearly the entire eastern half of the nation are quite cold for April. San Diego County is laying out plans to protect its senior citizens, which has been a 37% rise in crimes against seniors. San Diego County District Attorney Summer Stephen has launched a new initiative to go after a scourge of elder abuse in March this year. I'll be back. Stay logged on to IndianTimesDaily.com as news from Punjab follows. Welcome back to Indian Times Daily. The top 10 headlines from Punjab are: Rajya Sabha MP Shwet Malik has slammed the state Congress government for not fulfilling its promises given to voters. He also gave a call for the Congress Quit Punjab movement. The Indian Embassy in Saudi Arabia is concerned over the rising number of illegal migration cases of males to Gulf countries. Punjab has been urged to spread awareness over the issue, particularly in the district sending unskilled and semi-skilled women workers. SAD leaders want CM Amrinder Singh to resign from the post over the infighting among senior Punjab police officials. SAD MP Priyam Singh said that the law and the order machinery has collapsed as now the top police officials are levelling serious allegations against each other. A gangster lodged in Faridkot Central Jail has posted pictures of his birthday celebration on social media platforms. The noted gangster Bharat Bhushan had celebrated his birthday with other inmates inside the jail. Faridkot police have registered a case in the matter. The Punjab and Haryana court has ruled out the compensation awarded by an accident tribunal cannot be subjected to TDS. This means no taxes can be levied upon the interest received on the delayed compensation. It also claimed that it can take years for the compensation to be released. Mining department officials have come under the scanner of a cabinet subcommittee set up by CM Amrinder Singh to look into the mining policy. These officials assess the quantity of mines and minerals at the auction quarries. IPS officer who heads the STF on drugs Harpreet Singh Sidhu has been divested from the charge of Additional Director General of Police. He will now supervise Inspector General of Police, Bhatinda and Border Zones. Besides Sidhu, 31 other IPS officers have been transferred by the state government. SAD Amritsar Chief Simranjit Singh Mann will hold a conference at the Tilwandi Sabo on Baisakhi along with other radical Sikh organizations. Mann demanded action against the Mor bomb blast and the Barkari sacrilege accused. He also wants a probe into the allegation made by the Finance Minister Manpreet Badal against Badals. Rural Development and Panchayats Minister Trip Rajendra Singh Bajwa has said that there will be no changes in the upcoming Panchayat elections. He claimed that the election will be organized under the existing rules and regulations of the Panchayati Raj institutions. SAD's SC Wing Chief Gulzar Singh Ranike has demanded cancellation of various FIRs against the SC community members who participated in the April 2nd protest. Several members had hit the streets over the alleged dilution of SCST Act by the Supreme Court. This is the end of the news bulletin, but stay tuned to IndianTimesDaily.com as news from Bollywood is coming up next. And do visit the resources section on this portal to find the best into American businesses and resources from accounting firms to wedding planners in your city. All of us at Indian Times Daily wish that you have a great day.
Actor Rajkumar Rao, who is busy promoting his upcoming film Omerta, says that he wanted to explore his villainous side with this film. Rajkumar interacted with media during the promotion of the film on Friday. Asked that what prompted him to play the dark character of terrorist Omar Saeed Sheikh, he said,
"As actors, you know, we get very fascinated with the villains sometimes. Like you've seen it in past, like Shah Rukh Sir, be it Bhasikar or Dar or Amit Sir in Earth, 1947. Sanju Baba in Khalnayak or recently Ranveer in Padmavat. There's something edgy about these, you know, villains that we get attracted to as artists. I think it's, I don't know, it's the power that these guys have, or the it's the limitless approach that these guys have that, you know, we want to explore. So with, same with me, I think I wanted to explore this this villain inside me, because I've always done either grey characters or good boys. There's something different I wanted to explore, and Omerta gave me that opportunity.
Talking about the basic plot of the film, Rajkumar said,
फिल्म का नाम है ओमेर्टा, रिलीज हो रही है 20 अप्रैल को, और ओमेर्टा का मतलब होता है जब दो लोगों के बीच में एक साइलेंस बना होता है किसी चीज़ को लेकर, वो शेयर नहीं करते हैं बाहर, तो उसको गैंगस्टर टर्म में ओमेर्टा कहते हैं। और ये कहानी है ओमर सईद शेख की और इस जैसे बहुत लड़कों की जो ब्रेन वॉश होकर यू नो ऐसी टेररिस्ट एक्टिविटीज़ को अंजाम देते हैं, और स्पेशली ओमर, क्योंकि दुनिया में पिछले 15 साल में जो भी बड़ी इंटरनेशनल टेररिज्म की एक्टिविटीज़ हुई हैं, भले ही वो 9/11 हो अमेरिका में, मुंबई में 26/11 हो, कांधार हाईजैक हो, डैनियल पर्ल हो पाकिस्तान में जो उनकी किडनैपिंग और किलिंग थी, उस सब में उमर का हाथ रहा है। तो एक ऐसी दुनिया की कहानी है जिससे हमें जिसके बारे में हमें ज़्यादा मालूम नहीं है, और इसको बनाया हंसल सर ने, हंसल मेहता ने, जिसके साथ हम जिनके साथ हम मैंने पहले भी यू नो कुछ फिल्म्स की हैं, एंड जिन लोगों ने देखी उनका कहना है कि ये ओमेर्टा हंसल सर की बेस्ट फिल्म है आज तक की। तो 20 अप्रैल को आ रही है। यस, इट्स अ थ्रिलर।
ओमेर्टा इज अ बायोग्राफिकल क्राइम ड्रामा फिल्म डायरेक्टेड बाय हंसल मेहता and stars Rajkumar in the role of Ahmed Omar Saeed Sheikh, British terrorist of Pakistani descendant. Omerta is scheduled. Actor-comedian Kapil Sharma has agreed that he wrote offensive and abusive posts on his Twitter page. He said, "Maine jo bhi likha tha, apne dil se likha tha. It was my team who deleted my tweets. But main is bikayu reporter se darne wala nahi hu. He can write anything for anybody just for few bucks. Shameless." A slew of offensive and abusive posts from his Twitter page left fans of Kapil surprised on Friday. Tweets on his official handle included one requesting the media to not make Salman Khan's conviction news negative, whereas a few posts addressed fake news. Others had abusive language in Hindi. Besides writing offensive tweets, Kapil has also lodged a complaint against a journalist where the subject read, "Threat to extort and harassment by a news agency on the instance of ex-managers to cause mental and emotional suffering." The complaint also suggested that Kapil is very disturbed by line of comments like a failed actor, celebrity out of control, choice of wrong life partner.